it's Sarah, and I'm back today again. I have been really feeling my craft room lately. I have a clay project that I really want to do, and I have a lot of stuff going on in my head. Wanted to talk though. A couple of you guys have been asking me about the Posca paint pens, and I have to say, you know, I say use what you have, use what you have. But if you don't have these, I wouldn't mind if you got these. they're one of my favorite new craft supplies that I've gotten since I started with mixed media and all that stuff. Now, yesterday was the first time I ever used the Sharpie paint pens. And these seem to be pretty good too. And a paint pen is different from a marker because it's paint, it flows out of the nib. So it's a different feel, but these are the oil-based Sharpies. Just because when I was at AC Moore, I went to AC Moore to get the birdhouses, and I just saw the display for these, and I knew I didn't have orange and purple of these. Okay, now that being said, this is the Fine Point Posca paint pens. This is the 8-pack. I did just order a 12-pack because I have been using I guess the really chubby ones and the medium. So I have thick, medium, and fine. But I use the fine, and I think these are called, I should look it up, extra fine. I will put a link in the description box for the 12-pack of these, which comes with orange, purple, and brown. 9, 10, 11, and then what's the other color? I think there's like a light green in there. Of the Fine Point, and they're like 20 bucks on Amazon. So I will put the link for that. And I think they're called, let me go to Amazon. I'm just going to my Amazon account and see if, yeah, here they are. They call them Extra Fine Point Set of 12 Uni Posca Paint Marker Pen. And I'll put the link. They're $19 with Prime, which I ordered them because, like I said, I didn't have the orange, the purple, or brown, but the 8 set is very good too. It has very good colors. So all right, these, what I love about these is the point is so fine. So for doodling, like look how fine that is. Doodle, right? It's super fine, but it flows like a marker, so I mean like a paint, like paint. So look how easy it is to color. So I'll show you the difference with the different tips. So this is considered a 0.7, so 0.7. And if you look at the container, it's all written in another language. Like I guess it's Chinese, it could be Japanese, I don't know. It's in an Asian text. And the only thing it says is Uni Posca, and down it says 8 colors, and right here 0.7. But this is what I go by. When I look at the picture, I zoom in to see that 0.7, and that's the size for the extra fine point, okay? This is the 0.9 to 1.3, and I'll show you the difference. Let's look at, I'll do the red. I want to do a dark color. So this is what I would consider the medium point. So medium. Oh, I'm not even in the shot. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm sorry. I'm the worst. But I mean, see the difference? This is a medium point. That's a fine point. And then this is the bold one, and it goes 1.8 to 2.5. And again, it just says Uni Posca, and then everything else is written, and it says 8, so there's 8 in here. And then let's do, and I haven't used these in a long time, but if you're going to do sign making, like if you're making posters and things like that for like kids, this is wonderful. So let's go wonderful, right? So that's the fattest one. This is the medium. And this is the fine. Where's my fine pens? I don't, oh, I hid them. Alright, so that's, I wanted to tell you about these, but like I said, I will put the link in the description box, and you can see the different, that's the width lines, okay? But these are the best for doodling. Like, you can make little, I mean, they're so, and look how they don't skip or anything. They're just, they go on and on and on forever. So, I've used these a lot, and I don't know how much paint is still left in them, and I'll use them till they run out. But I got that other pack because I just know that I will always like this size. This is like my go-to size. I just keep this right next to me. These I don't even keep next to me. I keep them over, like, I may even just give them to Maya at some point if she's going to do posters or something like that, you know? So, I just wanted to tell you guys that. So, that link for that pack will be put in the description box, okay? I didn't do a very good show of these. These were the Pen Touch pens. I don't know what's in here, guys, but man, these are a very good metallic pen. Now, I've tried, I have these. These are very good. These are the Permopaque. I think they're called Permopaque, but I wasn't crazy about the gold color. I don't even know where my gold is because it's probably in here. This is where I keep all my, like, my go-to pens. But I've tried a lot of different metallic pens and stuff like that. I don't see it, but it's here somewhere. But I wasn't crazy about the gold. Let me just see if I see it. Here, this is it. And you don't have to shake these. This is, says opaque pigment marker. It's a 1.0 fine point, water and fade resistant. No shaking or pumping required. So let's see how this works. See, it's more like a magic marker. This is definitely more like a magic marker. And on paper, I don't know. I just never loved it. Let's see how it colors. I mean, it colors okay, but it's a marker. It's like a brush tip marker almost. But these, this is called Pen Touch, and this is by Sakura. And Sakura is an awesome name brand. If you get anything by Sakura, you're going to be good to go. These are the Micron pens. Sakura makes, what else? They make the Koi watercolor brushes. Oh, just a ton. They're just, Sakura is a good brand, but I don't know what's in here. It says, let's look at it. But these are the ones that I'm loving right now. And I like the color of this gold. Pen Touch, right? By Sakura. And then it says, quick dry, permanent opaque, 1.0 fine point. Before you shake well with cap, with nib up, press nib to release internal pressure. Press nib down until the ink flows. So it's ink. Do not over pump. So it's an ink. And I mean, I guess it's a permanent ink. And it does have an odor to it. It smells like, it kind of smells like spray paint. But see, look at the color of it. It's gold. It's much golder. I don't like it on paper either, but I'll tell you, on here, this is what I've been doing on my, so I'm going to show you guys the leaves too. So I'm going to go, you saw me in the tutorial do this, but on paint, like, I'm in love, and this did not smudge at all. I mean, it's gorgeous. So, I mean, and you can always just use your paint, guys. You can use your acrylic paints to do this stuff. But if you like pens and you like markers and, you know, I know a lot of us have pen addictions too. Like, anywho, this one, I just discovered this Pen Touch. I think I've had it in my stash too, and I just never used it. But it's gorgeous. So, because all, then I think I have Sharpie. Let me show you real quick the Sharpie. I've tried, the Sharpie metallics are good. I do like them. They come in a 3-set too. They always usually come with the bronze, is it? bronze, silver, and gold, right? But here's the color of this gold. It's still not, well, that's, you know why I must be storing it. That does not even look gold on here. Maybe running out. Let's see what the silver looks like. The silver looks good. And here's the bronze. Yeah, I think I must, this might have been stored, because it's just a Sharpie. It's a permanent marker. And I mean, but I just never loved the color either. The color just wasn't what I consider a pretty gold. And I'm sorry I'm so out of the shot. So this is what this was. And it's not even coming out. Anywho, I just really wanted to talk to you guys about this. The Pen Touch is so amazing. This is the bronze Pen Touch. Look at that ink just flow right out of there. And it's so, it's great. Great. I don't know if I'm in the shot again. Jesus. All right, so these are fantastic. The Permo Peak, whatever. These are good for a marker, but they're not as fine. This is a 1.0, but it's not the same. And then the fine point is 0.7, so that's why it's even a finer point. All right, enough of that. My last house, I did with white embossing powder. I just wanted to see what it would look like. And I have to say, I think I favor the black, but it's still cute. All right, so I'm gonna finish these up and show, I mean, I just think the black enhances the color, everything about it. I use this. This is called Whispers Opaque, and I got this at AC Moore. I don't know what brand that is, Whispers. It's by, well, it's made in the USA, packaged in China. That seems weird. Anywho, and it's just opaque white, I'm pretty sure. Seafoam white, so it's not a white either. And I think, I'm no expert on embossing powders, but if you get embossing powder, get extra fine if you can, because it just makes, like I was telling you yesterday, when I press too hard with a stamp and make, then extra fine at least doesn't come out too clumpy. Anyway, it saves you. So get extra fine if you can help it. So what I want to do right now is a quick tutorial, and I've done these before, guys, the one-stroke leaves. I know I was out of the shot yesterday, and I'll pay attention and make sure I'm definitely in the shot to show you these, because they're so simple. You need to practice. They don't come overnight, but it's basically a stroke leaf. So let me get out some paint, and I'll show you those, and I'm going to do them on here too. But you can do them one color or two color or three colors. You can do as many as you want. But the idea, now I use a little bit of water on my brush. Now let's go in and I'll get close so you can see. And it's a very subtle movement that you do. I'm using a number 4 filbert brush, which is flat, but it has the tip cut, like rounded on the top. So that gives you that nice base for your leaf, and then you make the tip when you pick it up. So I'm loading my brush. I'm pulling paint from the puddle. I'm not just, I don't have like a blob of paint on my brush. So you have to do it right if you want it to look right, okay? So I've loaded my brush. Now, one stroke. I'm just gonna put the brush down flat, and all I'm doing is kind of like a little push with my thumb to make that tip. So, or you can even put it down sideways if that helps you. But see, you want to come up on the chisel. You make the bottom, and then you make the point. So if you do it in a stroke, it makes a leaf. And listen, you can make them as sloppy as you want, because when I outline them, I fix the shape. So I'm going to load it in the dark green, and then I'm just going to take a tiny corner load of the light green, put a little bit on my brush, blend it in a little bit, And then when you make your leaf, you get a two-tone effect. And I can go, see, and it depends how, if you kind of stroke it and pull, like I could just be sloppy and go like that. You know what I mean? That you have to do purpose. So put down and kind of slide it, but it's really a very subtle twist of my thumb like this. All right, so let me go to my piece and I'll show you. You don't have to be perfect on here. You just want that shape. Am I too close? Because I come out of the shot so easy. And I'm going to double load this, so I'm going to go a little dark green and that little side load of other of the light green. And let's put a couple on this side. And I use my pinky to support my hand. And I put the brush down. And it's a subtle pull like that. I want a little more of the light green. And I'm going to do the same thing. There's just a dip in the wood. But when I outline everything, it'll come to life. So let's put one over here. And up here. And here. You don't want to go crazy. So just that many, and it makes a difference. So let's go down here. I'm just pulling paint from the puddle, scooping a little of that light green, and I'm going to do one, two, and I think that's all you need. This can be such a quick process if you just, you know, let's do a couple. And the smaller the brush, see my other one that I used yesterday, it was fraying and I didn't like it. It was a bit smaller. But they make smaller filberts. You can do it with a flat brush too. And it's the same process. Your bottom just might not be as rounded looking. And if I just use the very tip of the brush, I might even get a smaller leaf. So if it depends, because I can make a super big one if I push down and pull up. So you can make them as big as the brush allows, you know. Or if I just keep it real close, I'm going to go with much lighter paint. Maybe I'll just load it in the light green for this because it's a darker color background. Still like that dark though. Alright, so this is a one stroke leaf with a filbert brush. Let's put one over here and a couple going this way. And even if I don't get that nice pointy tip, I can fix that. I should use the lighter color. So I'll just get some light color and just go right on top and just brighten it up a little. Let's put a couple on the front. And because this is green, I'm going to use the darker green. And whatever's left on my brush, let's go this side. Since I'm going to put leaves here, I'll go to this side this time. And just try and make them small. And see how it got a little lumpy, but that's okay. So let's see, have I gotten all of the sides? Yep, I think I'm done. So that is the basic shape, right? Now I'm going to actually outline with white because everything's embossed with white. So I'm going to get my white paint out, which I didn't have out. It's right here. And we're going to use a liner brush and really do the same thing. I want to make, this is what I kind of figured out after doing all of these. When I did this one, and I didn't show you guys this one yet. This one's done. Moving my, so this is that little file folder I was showing you, and I started over. Originally I had done it like the ATC cards I did, but I changed it, and I like how it turned out. I think it just looks cleaner looking this way, you know. I did a couple of flowers on each side. So this is what I want to show you. See how when I outlined it with the black, I pulled it from the tips this time. Instead of yesterday, I was just kind of doing it from any angle I had the leaf. But this time I did it purposefully with my liner brush. Let me get my liner brush. Push down and pull, and I pulled them all down. So, and I just like the way that looks. Let me go in real close and just show you those little leaves. Now, some of them, and I could fix every shape. I gave every shape a nice tip. And so you can fix everything. So if you just go around real quick and do your the green parts of your leaves, you don't have to be perfect at it. You can fix all that with your liner brush. So let me show you how I'm going to do that. And I'm going to use white today. So we'll start on the blue. That should show up really nice. Now, I am using a 10/0 liner, script liner actually. So a script, the bristles are a bit longer too. Take some water on my brush, and I'm going to make this white paint kind of, they say make it inky, into an ink-like consistency. So just add a little bit of water. You're not adding a ton of water at all. And load your brush. Now when I load my brush, I pull the paint through the bristles. I'm not in the shot. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry. I don't do well with zooming. So I'm pulling my brush through the paint. Now, when you make these, I'm going to do the actual comma part of the stroke on the bottom of each, or to the left side. So I'm going to put my brush down and pull it down the left side of the leaf. And then I'm just going to do it very thin on the other side. It doesn't have to be thick. Do the same thing. Push down, pick up, and go around. And then we'll just attach them. So see how, I don't know, I just think it, and it adds to the painted look of it as well. It makes it look a little more, not professional, but you know. So basically, see how it looks? All right, let's do this side. This is another dark side. Well, the white should show up pretty good on this. So I have my brush loaded. I put down the tip and let it really make a nice stroke there, and then you really just stay up on the tip. If you want a thin, very thin line, you stay up on the tippiest tip of the brush, because if you push down, it's going to be thicker. You're going to, you know, so I push down a little bit on the tip and then pick up as I pull. And this is really fun for me. It's so fun. But don't get worked up over it. Just try and do it as quickly as you can. You know, and it makes it look, like I say, a little more, it makes it look painterly. Like you know what you're doing, even though it looks messy. It's like intentional, almost, messiness. Which, I'm not trying to be messy, don't get me wrong. I think you know what I mean. So I think the white's showing up pretty good. Like I said, I do prefer the black embossing, but I just wanted to see, because my original, oops, my finger slipped. My original, the one I saw on Pinterest was a lot of white outline and stuff. So, but I think it looks pretty, like on the dark, doesn't that look pretty? So let's do it, the red you'll see, let's do it on a lighter color and see. Now look how sloppy my embossing was on here. I think I forgot to use my embossing buddy, which it's like powder, but I have a bunch of white speckles all in there, and I could have wiped that away. I think I was just being lazy this morning when I did it. So let's do these leaves. I have Don't forget to really be up on the tip if you want that to be a fine point. I mean, a fine line. But isn't this like meditative? I find it so relaxing. It's just wonderful. And I mean, I know a lot of my subscribers, because I do so many things, aren't actually, didn't get to know me through painting. But I'll tell you what, guys, if you've ever had an inkling to try it, you should try it. And it does take practice, but it's a teachable, it's a learnable skill. You can absolutely learn to use the paintbrush, and it's fun. It's just so fun. And I mean, I'm coming back to my painting techniques a lot more, and I'm loving bringing that into my mixed media and everything. So I have to touch this up. All right, so let's have a look. I'm hoping I was in the shot for the most part. I'm gonna try and stay kind of zoomed in. Let me move this out of the way. Get it focused. The only thing I don't like I probably should have used, I think I'm gonna go over that yellow. It's just too light, that flower, but I love like the top. All right, and then you could use the paintbrush to make your I think I am. I'm gonna just, since I have this white paint out, I'm gonna show you what I mean. I've just been using my Posca paint pen to create these little flake lines. But, and I mean, it's a little more, obviously, it's a little more fiddly doing it with the, I like to pull dash lines toward me. It's just easier. So that's why I kind of stopped going. Doesn't that look pretty? I love those little flake pattern lines. They're so cute. I have only have one more butterfly over here. But yeah, you can do all of this stuff without the Posca paint pens at all. But I had them, so I had to tell you guys. Oh, this is getting crazy, huh? Because I want to go up there. Oh, well, make a sharp turn. We're going behind the bird. Cute. I don't know if I love it as much as the dark. I'm just saying. For some reason, the dark embossing really made everything, the colors seem brighter to me. The background, I'm sorry, the flower painting. I just want to fix this. I have some black paint. So what else did I want to tell you? Kirby's trying to go out. Let me think. Alright, so I have, this is my gold perma, no, not that one, this one. I think on this one, because I've used so much white, I don't know if I'm going to make the white dip dots. I might just go with gold on the edge of the eaves of the roof there. Let's try it. I'm going to get gold paint. And I don't want to use up this magic marker, you know, to do it. But this metallic by Dazzling Metallics by DecoArt is a very pretty cool. This is called Glorious Gold. There's probably other colors, but let's see. I want to put it here, and I'm just using my finger, and I want to put it, because it's a flat edge, my finger can do a very good job without getting it, and even if it does go over the edge a little bit, I don't mind. But that just adds, see, I like that. This will be fine without the white dots. Do you like that? I don't know. I should have made dip dots. That's what I'll do. I'll make gold dip dots instead of just painting the whole thing. And because it's paint and it's very wet, I can wipe it right off. But all right, I think that's basically what I wanted to talk about today. Just wanted to answer a few of your questions about the paint pens, the Posca paint pens, and the other thing, I know I've been smudging a lot, and I have workable fixative, I have the other Krylon, As well, and I'm just lazy, and I have to go outside to spray this, so I just tend to just start varnishing. And I wanted to tell you about my varnish. Right now I'm using, there are other varnishes out there, but this is just what's available at the craft store. I use either the Delta Ceram Coat, whatever craft paint brand they have, and I ran out of my gloss because I did use the gloss finish for these because it's such, it makes the color just that more much more vibrant. But this is satin. I'm pretty sure I did this one in satin because I ran out of the gloss. So I mean, it's still pretty, but this is just really shinier. All right, so I think that's everything I wanted to share. I am going to have to figure out what I want to do next because I'm thinking I want to make that polymer clay piece. No, that's not going to be a class. Okay, good, yeah. I'll come back and do, I'm going to do a polymer clay, one of these, I think. But I want to use these boho colors. I'm going to make a pencil holder. Well, I use them for my paint brushes. So I have this one, which I did kind of more like Christine Capano, because I took a class with her. But I think I want to do one with these bright colors, and I have some ideas for the patterns to be like more paisley and stuff, kind of like this, but I'm going to try and make it more flowery and boho. We'll see how it goes. All right, so that's it. I hope that was helpful, and thanks for watching.